Hello everyone, am I audible and visible to you? Okay. So let me introduce myself, Dr. Sheetal Pipalia, your faculty for physiology. Welcome to the platform of An Academy. Now, with An Academy, you will be able to go through the different subjects of MBBS. I am here to teach you physiology. Welcome to An Academy Future Doctors. I did MD Physiology from MP Shah Medical College, Jamnagar, and I am educating MBBS and MD students. I have teaching experience of more than 17 years and I am one of the experienced faculty for integrated curriculum teaching. Now let us go through some subscription details of An Academy. With plus subscription, you will have access to both live as well as recorded classes. You can learn from the topmost educators of India for medical exams. You can compete in live tests and quizzes. You can study on the device of your own choice. You can have access to the question bank having more than 25,000 questions in it. You can even have a printed notes which are available with certain subscriptions. Then iconic subscription. With iconic subscription, you will have access to two platforms, An Academy as well as PrepLetter. Both are having different resources. With An Academy, you can have access to the recorded classes which are covering the full syllabus, question bank, competition in the live tests and quizzes, live batches, and many more. And with the PrepLetter, clinical and integrated essential that you can find video lectures from the dream team, question bank with active guidance and system tags and many more, rapid revision and snapshot, dream notes. Like that, you will get such things from the PrepLetter. So both are unique in its own way. With iconic subscription, you can have access to best from the two. All the subscriptions are available with different duration and different prices. You can use the promo code, that is Sheetal10, SHITAL10, Sheetal10, to get the additional discount. Now, how to prepare for the exams, how to prepare different subjects like physiology. So for that, you can attend the live classes and you can prepare the notes while attending the class itself, because I am preparing this all topics by referring different books. So you can have in one lecture only, you will get so much of the content, or you can have prepared notes which are available with the certain subscriptions, or you can go for the books which are available in the market. Now, let us go through cardiovascular system. Today's topic is shock. What is shock? Let us understand the definition of the shock first. It is generalized. Understand the word carefully. It is generalized. Generalized inadequacy of the blood flow throughout the body. Generalized inadequacy of the blood flow throughout the body to the extent that body tissue will be damaged. Okay, because of the too little blood flow. So it is generalized inadequacy of the blood flow throughout the body, which will cause tissue damage because of the very, very less blood flow. There are different types of the shock. First one is a hypovolemic shock, also known as a cold shock. This is important. This is asked also. Okay, hypovolemic shock, another name is a cold shock. Here, the amount of fluid in the vascular system is inadequate. Okay, hypovolemia goes, word itself suggests, hypo means less, lesser volume. So, amount of fluid in the vascular system is inadequate to fill the vascular system. So, it results in decreased circulating blood volume. So tissue will suffer from ischemic damage. So tissue damage occurs. Okay. Different causes of hypovolemic shock are hemorrhage, loss of blood, trauma, that is traumatic shock. Because of surgery during intraoperative period, if there is a loss of blood, because of dehydration, severe diarrhea, vomiting can also cause fluid loss. So, fluid loss will cause decrease in the extracellular fluid volume. So, blood volume will be reduced. So, that can also cause hypovolemic shock. So, different causes of hypovolemic shock or cold shock are hemorrhage, trauma, surgery because of surgery, or during dehydration. Because of dehydration, hypovolemia if occurs. The another variety, another type of the shock is distributive shock. Distributive shock, another name is vasogenic or low resistance or warm shock. All the names are important to remember. Okay. In exams, it is asked. Okay. Distributive shock or vasogenic shock or low resistance shock or warm shock. Here, what will happen? See, understand the word carefully. Vasogenic. So, here, what will happen? Size of the capacitance vessels. Capacitance vessels are veins. Right. So, it will be increased by vasodilatation. So, large amount of the blood will be adjusted in the capacitance vessels. Simply by changing the shape of the capacitance vessels from the elliptical into the circular, it can accommodate the large amount of blood in the vessels. Okay. So, by causing vasodilatation, if it becomes circular, then also it will be able to adjust the large blood volume. So, blood volume will be despite of normal blood volume, amount of blood coming back to the heart will be reduced, venous return. So, it will decrease the cardiac output. Okay. Different causes of distributive shock are varieties, you can say, or causes are neurogenic shock, that is fainting, anaphylaxis, anaphylactic shock, or sepsis, septic shock. Then, another type, that is cardiogenic shock. Cardiogenic shock, the word itself says some problem with the heart which causes shock. So, problem with the heart is inadequate pumping. Inadequate pumping action of the heart will cause decrease in the stroke volume and decrease in the cardiac output. Okay, because of any myocardial abnormality, if inadequate pumping of the blood occurs, which results in decrease in the cardiac output, so tissue will suffer from ischemia. So tissue will suffer from ischemic damage. Okay, different causes of cardiogenic shock are myocardial infarction, congenital heart diseases, different types of arrhythmia, cardiac arrhythmias, all can cause shock. Okay, then obstructive shock. Word itself suggests obstructive means obstruction to the blood flow in the lungs or in the heart. So, because of the obstruction, stroke volume reduces, cardiac output reduces, and tissue ischemic damage will occur. Different causes of obstructive shock are tension pneumothorax, pulmonary embolism, cardiac tumor, or cardiac tamponade. Now come to the different stages of the shock. Okay, if there is a decrease in the fluid volume or there is a decrease in the blood volume because of loss of blood. Right. So, compensatory mechanisms. Okay, when the shock is non-progressive, different compensatory mechanism will be activated. This all I covered in regulation of blood pressure. Okay, that is baroreceptor reflex, CNS ischemic response, reverse stress relaxation, formation of angiotensin by kidneys, and release of antidiuretic hormone from the posterior pituitary. Now, the baroreceptor reflex mechanism and CNS ischemic response is something which is the short term regulatory mechanisms, those mechanisms which can control the blood pressure within seconds. Okay, so by baroreceptor reflex mechanism, it will increase the sympathetic discharge and try to increase the blood pressure. So tissue blood flow will be improved. Okay, increase in the tissue blood flow and ischemia will be relieved. Then CNS ischemic response is the response when there is an extreme fall in mean blood pressure. Mean blood pressure less than 50 mmHg. It will be activated when mean blood pressure reduces to 50 mmHg. That time brain will suffer from ischemia, right? So because due to lack of blood flow, less blood flow to the brain. So in that case, there will be strong stimulation of the vasomotor center will occur. And it will cause massive peripheral sympathetic discharge. So, what will happen from the, because of strong vasoconstriction in the peripheral parts of the body, it will cause the more and more venous return towards the heart. Okay, from the entire peripheral parts of the body, large amount of blood, because of strong peripheral vasoconstriction, blood will be returned. The tissue blood flow is diverted toward the brain in order to relieve ischemia to the brain. So that is a CNS ischemic response. Then reverse stress relaxation, that I explained in the special classes of regulation of blood pressure. Reverse stress relaxation. Okay, whenever this is blood vessel, if the blood flowing through the vessel is reduced, then the tissue will be tightened. Okay, by the myogenic tone, the vessel will be tightened. Okay, and try to maintain the blood flow. Okay, that is reverse stress relaxation. Then formation of the angiotensin by kidneys. Angiotensin 2. Okay, it is important for vasoconstriction and it also causes salt and water retention by acting on kidney. So by both of this way, it will increase the blood volume. By causing the vasoconstriction, it increases the blood pressure. So that way it will try to compensate. Then by release of antidiuretic hormone. Okay, the word itself suggests antidiuretic hormone. Hormone which prevents diuresis means the hormone which prevents the fluid loss out of the body. So ADH will act on kidneys, right, and it will prevent the fluid loss via urine. So it will increase the extracellular fluid volume. So it will increase the blood volume. So it will increase the blood pressure. So tissue ischemic damage will be relieved. So these all are the compensatory mechanisms for hypovolemic shock. Now, another one is a progressive shock. See the word carefully, progressive shock. So here what will happen, that some changes which occurs, which causes more and more damage. Okay, more and more damage. So here what will happen? There is a cardiac depression because the blood flow is reduced to the tissue. So majority of the body tissue will start suffering from the ischemic damage. So what happens in cardiac depression? That is because of reduced myocardial blood flow. So heart cardiac depression will occur. So it will decrease the pumping ability of the heart. So it will set the positive feedback mechanism, right? That decreased pumping ability of the heart will decrease the stroke volume. So it will cause decrease in the cardiac output, decrease in the blood pressure. So again, there is a tissue ischemia. Right, once tissue ischemia is there, blood flow to the myocardium is less, causing myocardial depression. Again, the entire cycle will be repeated. Right, so it is progressive. Right, progressive, like condition is getting worsened. The another one is vasomotor failure. That is because of the reduced blood flow to the brain. Up to some extent, CNS ischemic response will try to compensate. Right? Beyond that, if the blood flow reduces to the brain, if it is for the longer time, then the vasomotor center will fail. So that sympathetic discharge and peripheral vasoconstriction and diverting the blood flow to the brain, that entire mechanism will be lost, right? So that is a vasomotor failure. Then blockage of minute blood vessels, small blood vessels. Because the blood flow is reduced, the blood flow is sluggish. Once the blood flow is sluggish, it may cause the formation of the clot, minute blood clots. Okay, and it will block the smaller capillaries, okay, smaller vessels. Once the capillaries or a smaller blood vessels are plugged, then tissue next to it will suffer from ischemia. So that is a progression, more and more worsening of the condition. Then increase in the capillary permeability. If capillary permeability will increase, then fluid will move from the blood vessel into the interstitium. Right, so it will cause edema in the individual, and because of the fluid movement, because the fluid is moving, it reduces the blood volume. Already blood volume is less, because of increase in the capillary permeability, it causes more fluid movement from the vascular compartment into the interstitium, causing edema. So it is worsening the, and there is a further decrease in the blood volume. Already blood volume is less, because of increase in the capillary permeability, fluid is moving in the interstitium, causing edema, causes further decrease in the blood volume, right? Then release of toxins by ischemic tissues. Certain toxins like histamine, this is important to remember, like histamine, serotonin, and different tissue enzymes. These toxins will cause tissue damage. Then there will be generalized cellular deterioration. Functions of the cells will be deteriorated. What sort of functions? There will be decrease in the transport of sodium and potassium. Right? So here what will happen? There is a increase in the fluid movement inside the cell. So it will cause cellular swelling. Then decrease in the mitochondrial activity. So mitochondria is a powerhouse of the cell. So the energy providing by the mitochondria to the cell is reduced. Then breakdown of the lysosomes. Lysosomes are suicidal bags, you can say, right? It will release the different enzymes which will cause digestion. So it will break down of the lysosomes will cause release of these enzymes in the tissue itself. So in the cell or in the tissue itself. So it will cause tissue damage. Right? And overall cellular metabolism is reduced. So overall functions of the cells are reduced. So this way, cellular deterioration, generalized cellular deterioration will occur. Now, acidosis, because of the excess of lactic acid in the blood, because the mitochondrial activities are reduced and tissue blood flow is also reduced, right? So it will go for the anaerobic metabolism, for the energy production, right? So there will be more formation of lactic acid. So there is a acidosis. This is important to remember. Okay. So these all are the what happens, different mechanisms which will cause further and further progression of the shock. First one, because of the failure of the compensatory mechanism to compensate the hypovolemic shock, then the person enters into the progressive shock. Once the person enters into the progressive shock, these things will happen. Cardiac depression, because heart is having lesser blood flow. Vasomotor failure, that is because of the decrease in the mean blood pressure, and that is extreme decrease in the mean blood pressure. So for decrease in the blood flow to the brain will cause vasomotor failure. Now vasomotor center is not capable to produce, to have that response which will balance the blood flow to the brain. Then blockage of the minute vessels, formation of the blood clot in the vessels will further causes increase in the tissue damage, because it will cause the plugging of the minute vessels. So tissue next to it will cause suffer from the ischemia. Increase in the capillary permeability. Already blood volume is less. Still, because the capillary permeability is increased, fluid is moving from the vascular compartment into the interstitium. So further decrease in the blood volume will occur. Then release of toxins like histamine, serotonin, tissue enzymes. It will also cause ischemic damage to the tissue. Then generalized cellular deterioration will occur, and because of excess of the lactic acid production in the blood, there will be acidosis. So this is the progressive shock. Now, in the progressive shock, what will happen here is decrease in the cardiac output. This entire mechanism will keep on occurring, okay? Decrease in the cardiac output will decrease the blood flow, systemic blood flow. So cardiac nutrition will decrease, so cardiac depression will occur, right? Then decrease in the cardiac output and decrease, this entire flow chart is important. I prepared specifically it so you can memorize it in a better way. Decrease in the cardiac output and decrease in the systemic blood flow. So what it will do? Decrease in the nutrition to the brain. If to the brain, nutrition is reduced, vasomotor activity is reduced, right? So if the vasomotor activity is reduced, it means vasoconstriction will not occur. If vasoconstriction is not occurring, means vasodilatation is occurring. So venous pooling of the blood will occur. Veins are capacitance vessels. It will accommodate the blood in the circulation, right? So there is a further decrease in the cardiac output, right? Already blood volume is less. Now because of the vasodilatation, blood is again, amount of blood available in the circulation is further reduced. So it will cause further decrease in the cardiac output. So it means that the entire cycle, that continuous vicious cycle is happening. Then another one is decrease in the nutrition to the vascular system. So if the vascular system means blood vessels, right? So there will be venodilatation. So venous pooling of the blood will occur, right? Because of the vasodilatation, there is a venous pooling of the blood. So again, further decrease in the cardiac output. There is increase in the capillary permeability. So blood is moving, fluid is moving into the interstitium, right? So further decrease in the blood volume. So further decrease in the cardiac output. So that cycle will keep on occurring. Then tissue ischemia. Tissue ischemia will cause release of toxins. Again, it will cause increase in the capillary permeability. So fluid is moving into the interstitium. Further decrease in the blood volume causes further decrease in the cardiac output. So that is a positive feedback mechanism which keep on occurring and causes worsening of the shock. Decrease in the cardiac output and systemic blood flow will also cause intravascular clotting. So it decreases the venous return and further decrease in the cardiac output. So this all things will happen in the progressive shock. This happen because of the set mechanism, vicious cycle, that is a positive feedback mechanism. If it keeps on occurring, then the person will enter into irreversible shock. Okay, irreversible. Now it is not possible to retry, right? So what happened in the irreversible shock? There is a continuous deterioration. That entire cycle, entire mechanisms which causes progression of the shock is now in the positive feedback way, right? So keep on worsening the situation, okay? And there will be depletion of the cellular high energy phosphate reserves too, right? So because of this, the person enters into the stage of irreversibility. So it can decrease in the blood flow to the brain will cause altered sensorium. So these all are the clinical features of the shock. Now come to the next one, that is neurogenic shock. In neurogenic shock, word itself suggests, right? Neurons, something involved by neurons. There is a loss of vasomotor tone. It will cause venous dilatation. So, venous pooling of the blood will occur. So, large amount of blood is accommodated here. So, it will cause decrease in the venous return. Decrease in the venous return means decrease in the stroke volume. Means decrease in the cardiac output. So, there is a decrease in the mean blood pressure. So, that is a neurogenic shock. Different types of neurogenic shock are vasovagal shock, extreme stimulation of the vagus nerve, right? Anything which, like any emotion, even sudden news of sudden bad news can cause extreme vagal stimulation. You might have seen this in the movie also, that simply by listening the bad news, person faint. That is because of the extreme vagal stimulation. So, because of that, there will be strong parasympathetic discharge in the body. So, causes vasodilatation and causes decrease in the venous return. So, for a while, there will be lesser blood flow to the brain. So, there will be fainting. Then, postural syncope. When the person changes the position, like from supine to standing, usually what happens? There will be compensatory mechanism, baroreceptor reflex, right? Baroreceptor reflex will control the blood pressure. Second to second control of blood pressure will occur, right? So, if the reflex mechanism fails, in that case, change in the posture will also cause fainting of the individual, because from supine to standing position, the blood pressure reduces. So, while in a standing position, maybe because if the reflex mechanism is not that powerful, then the syncope will occur. Then micturition syncope. Syncope occur at the time of micturation because of the parasympathetic stimulation. Then carotid sinus syncope. Massage over the carotid sinus can also cause strong parasympathetic or vagal stimulation and person can faint. That is why the people who are wearing tight collar can have a strong compression over the carotid sinus, and it can cause a strong parasympathetic stimulation and fainting in the individual. Then cuff syncope. That is because of increase in the intrathoracic pressure when the person cough, okay, which causes compression on the vessels and the person may faint. Then effort syncope, that is because of the heavy exertion. Okay, so exercising muscle, in the exercising muscle, there will be dilatation of the vessels, which will cause peripheral pooling of the blood. So venous return reduces and it will cause decrease in the cardiac output. So there is a fall in blood pressure. Then deglutition syncope, word itself suggests, syncope occur at the time of deglutition. And neurocardiogenic syncope. So, these all are varieties of the neurogenic shock. Then the another one, that is anaphylactic shock. Understand the word carefully, anaphylactic. That happened because of antigen-antibody reaction. After entering of antigen into the circulation, which to whichever antigen the person is sensitive, when it enters in the body, it will cause antigen-antibody reaction. This reaction will cause venous and arteriolar dilatation. So, it will cause peripheral pooling. Peripheral pooling of the blood. Right? So, it will cause decrease in the venous return, decrease in the stroke volume, decrease in the cardiac output, so fall in blood pressure. Right? Same time, there is increase in the capillary permeability also. So, that will cause the fluid movement from the vascular compartment into the interstitial compartment. So, you might have seen also that the people who are having anaphylactic shock will have a redness and edema. Okay, that is because of increase in the capillary permeability, which will cause the fluid movement from the vascular compartment into the interstitium. Then, septic shock. That is because of the disseminated bacterial infection. To different areas of the body, many areas of the body, which will cause extensive tissue damage. Okay, extensive tissue damage. So because of the sepsis, the person will have a high grade fever, there will be vasodilatation, so fall in blood pressure will be there. Sepsis may cause increase in the cardiac output, it will cause sludging of the blood, right? So intravascular clotting may occur, okay, and there will be disseminated intravascular coagulation. Understand the word carefully. Disseminated intravascular coagulation means the clot are present throughout the body. So disseminated intravascular coagulation will cause tissue damage wherever there is a blockage of the vessel. Okay, like if the clot goes to the pulmonary circulation, in that case it will cause pulmonary embolism. Okay. In disseminated intravascular coagulation, it can cause pulmonary embolism if the clot moves to the pulmonary circulation. If it goes to the coronary blood vessel, then it will cause coronary occlusion, acute coronary occlusion. So there will be myocardial ischemia and later on there is a myocardial infarction. If it goes to the brain, then it will cause transient ischemic attack in the individual. So depend on the site, wherever the clot will move, okay, that tissue will suffer from ischemia and infarction. So that is disseminated, word itself says, disseminated intravascular coagulation. So this all are the features of septic shock. So this is all about shock. If you have any question, you can ask me. I would like to conclude the important parts here in the shock. Important points to remember here. The hypovolemic shock is also named as a cold shock. This is important to remember. The another variety, distributive or vasogenic or low resistance or warm shock. This you have to remember. Septic shock is a variety of distributive or a warm shock. Okay. Cardiogenic shock can occur because of arrhythmia, MI, and congestive heart failure. Then vasomotor failure occurs in progressive shock. There will be development of acidosis in the progressive shock. Then generalized cellular deterioration, what happens? That can be asked, that decrease in the active transport of the sodium and potassium. So there will be cellular swelling, reduced mitochondrial activity, breakdown of the lysosomes, and decrease in the cellular metabolism. Okay. Different toxins which can be released during progressive shock is histamine, serotonin, and tissue enzymes, different tissue enzymes. Then in irreversible shock, there will be continuous cellular deterioration and depletion of the cellular high energy phosphate reserve. Then neurogenic shock, these all are varieties, specifically the carotid sinus syncope, like those people who are wearing the tight collar, because of the compression over the carotid sinus, it can cause strong parasympathetic stimulation and person may faint. That is a variety of a neurogenic shock. Then vasovagal shock, any emotional disturbance which can cause strong parasympathetic stimulation. Any emotional disturbance which causes strong parasympathetic stimulation will cause peripheral vasodilatation and fainting of the individual. Disseminated bacterial infection causes septic shock, in which DIC, sludging of the blood, and disseminated intravascular coagulation can occur. Okay, and depend on the site where the clot will go and it will plug the minor capillaries. Depend on the site of the involvement, it will cause the typical feature like pulmonary embolism, myocardial infarction, and so on. Please like, share, and subscribe on Academy Future Doctors channel. So help us to reach more and more number of students. Thank you so much.